this week, Chris Stewart announced his retirement from the National Hockey League after more than a decade in the NHL. Played 668 games with seven different franchises, most recently with the Philadelphia Flyers. And take a look at this picture that he put together and then tweeted out, representing all seven franchises that he played for, with a very heartfelt message. And yeah, I mean, those are amazing chairs.
I like those chairs.
I would purchase one of those. I'd purchase that one in the middle there with that Minnesota Wild logo.
I'm sure you would.
Shocker. Look nice in my little two-bedroom apartment.
Yeah,
it's crazy. Anyway, I remember when Chris Stewart
Why are we not in them right here right now?
That'd be great. Yeah, Stewie, can you help us out? We're going to bring him in now from Minnesota. And let's start with the chairs there. How did you come up with the idea to announce your retirement in such a clever way?
Yeah, you know, it was a gift from my wife here. So it was a retirement gift. And, you know, there's a couple fans on Twitter that were quick to point out that it was about a quarter of the National Hockey League. So thanks for the reminder.
All right, Chris, if you had to sit in one of those chairs, which is the one you'd want to sit in?
I mean, they all represent a different part of the journey. So it all depends on the mood. But, you know, I kind of like the Anaheim Ducks one. This might be my favorite.
Okay. All right.
When you think about your career and you have those moments of reflection, what did you take from it? What meant the most to you and to Chris Stewart now that you have that moment to reflect and say, this was my career?
No, for sure. You know, it's no doubt about it. It's a success story. You know, if you look at that picture, it's a story about a small city kid from the inner city of Toronto who grew up to play 13 years professionally in the NHL. So, you know, any way you look at it, it's a badge of honor and it's a success story.
Chris, why was now really the right time? Why did you decide that, you know, I'm done chasing the game, done chasing the market, not going to deal with any of that, and instead move to the next phase of your life?
No, for sure. I mean, you know, the way I look at it is I made the NHL twice. You know, I made it when I was a 20-year-old kid, and I had a chance to make it again when I was 32 years old. So, you know, I thought throughout the pandemic, you know, we were kind of forced to all self-reflect and, you know, thinking about my next step going forward. And, you know, I got three kids who are all under the age of six, and I want to spend more time with my family. And, you know, I just felt the time is right now.
Chris, what's your favorite memory? What's your favorite moment when you look back on your career that comes to mind right away?
I mean, for sure, probably, you know, my first NHL goal. But, you know, for me, when my favorite NHL moment was probably scoring my first goal in Toronto in the ACC. You know, it was a pretty nice breakaway goal in Freddie Anderson, and then coming out to the stands after and had about 40 of my family members waiting there for me.
Awesome. You're a very physical player. You enjoyed that part of the game when you played, Chris. The game has changed even in your time. You know, you're 12, 13 years in the National Hockey League. With that said, are you comfortable with where the game is at right now? Do you like where it's at and how it has changed from when you were a youngster, a rookie, to where you are now retiring?
No, for sure. I think, you know, I think that's any sport and the evolution of any athlete, you know, the game's going to change. So, you know, it's definitely a lot more focused on speed and skill, but, you know, the game right now, you know, watching the Stanley Cup playoffs, watching Tampa Bay and Dallas go at it, you know, it's exciting hockey. It's great hockey, but, you know, it's good to see some of the older guys too, like Pavelski and Corey Perry and, you know, guys like Pat Maroon still doing their thing.
Speaking of the game changing for the better, I noticed you're wearing the Hockey Diversity Alliance hat and a sweatshirt as well. You're one of the founding members of this great group that is really trying to drive change for the better throughout the world of hockey, and specifically the NHL. I know you're also good friends with your former teammate, Matt Dumba, and when he started the Stanley Cup playoffs by talking about racial injustice and really having this heartfelt speech, what was that like for you and your family to watch from home?
No, it was great. It was an amazing moment. And I think I put out a tweet, you know, when my kids saw Uncle Dumbs there on the TV taking a knee in front of the world, you know, they're kind of a little bit too young to understand the magnitude of the moment and the things that are going on. But, you know, we're all very proud of him, and I'm great for him stepping up and, you know, being a leading face in this conversation.
Looks like you spent multiple Christmas mornings with Uncle Dumbs, as we see in your tweet here. Tell us about that relationship.
Yeah, you know, being an older guy in Minnesota, and, you know, during the schedule, you know, you don't really have time to travel home for Christmas anymore. So, you know, we'd take him in and have him over for Christmas morning and Boxing Day, and, you know, he'd spend a lot of time with us.
Chris, we're mentioning the Hockey Diversity Alliance. Where do you want to see this go in the future now? Because obviously you're retired, but you're going to have maybe some more time to devote to it. Where do you want to see this move as we move forward?
Oh, for sure. I think, you know, in hockey being a predominantly white sport, I think, you know, we have a chance to be a leader in this movement and really, really create effective change. And, you know, for me, being a father of three and, you know, having my sons who love playing hockey and going to the rink, you know, we just want to create a safe environment for them so, you know, they didn't have to deal with some of the things that we dealt with growing up.
Well, it sounds like you will have a really good opportunity to help a lot of guys, especially on the Philadelphia Flyers. I know your next chapter has officially been announced. You're going to be a player development coach for Philly. Before we let you go, real quick thoughts on what you're excited about that chapter.
No, for sure. You know, Philly's a first-class organization, and I really enjoy my short time there. But, you know, they got a lot of great people there and great positions, and, you know, I'm eager to get on there to learn underneath them and, you know, help the younger generation, you know, really succeed and reach their dreams, which is, you know, playing in the NHL full time.
Best of luck to you in that next chapter. And thanks so much for taking the time. Enjoy retirement.
All right, perfect. Thanks, guys.
And if your Minnesota chair is gone, it's Jamie. You know that.
Be careful. You might want to lock that down.
I'll send you my address. You can just ship it over. Thanks.